We're back. So, in the last video, I started writing a new book, Will's Big Bad Boring Brain Dump on Relational Programming. And you can see I've got a PDF in front of me of the book, and I checked it in the GitHub in Markdown. So, you can check out the Markdown in GitHub if you want. This is a new book that's CC BY for the license. And looks like I wrote a little more than 2 pages. The margins are huge, so not really worried about the page count. But the point is, made some progress. And most importantly, it was fun. It was fun because I was adhering to my new motto, which I heard in this Film Courage video, which was, what was it? It was write poorly, proudly. It was something like that. I put a to-do to look up that quote. I'll fill that in later. But I love that quote. Write poorly, proudly. And it also reminded me of something I heard in an interview with Ray Bradbury, which is, it was something along the lines of the typewriter has to be candy to the writer. It's like it's got to draw you to it. You've got to really want to get in there. And ever since I started thinking about this book, which hasn't been very long, it's been, I think, less than 24 hours. It was really this morning. I was like, yeah, I should just go ahead and do it. Sort of got this magnetic pull where I just want to work on it. So maybe they'll go by, maybe they'll go away, right? It's easy to be excited in the beginning. But that last session, which lasted about an hour, including 8 minutes of me gabbing at the beginning, I got coffee and I was like, all right, I want to write, get everything set up, start writing. And after I finished that session, I was like, well, all right, just did about 50 minutes of writing. I guess that's enough. And then it's like, I want to try it again. I just want to try it again. Got some more coffee. I'm ready to go. And when I was getting the coffee, I was thinking about what I want to work on. Let's try it again. Let's see if we can get another decent session in. Just see where it goes. And I don't know. It's just, there's also this Chinese saying I've read, which is something like the faintest handwriting is better than the best memory or something like that. I'm sure I'm butchering that phrase, but that's also the idea of this, is just to try to get down everything. So, yeah. All right. Well, let's try doing some more writing and let's see where that goes. So, I've been gabbing for 3.5 minutes. Let's keep going. Truth versus success. Let's talk about that. So one thing I could do is I could talk about some topics that came up recently. Let me just write down some topics here that I want to write about. So one was many worlds interpretation of logic programming. Okay, that was one thing. So he has turned into a silent video after all. Notice I'm not looking at my notes either that I've collected. I'm just, all right, what have I been thinking about? I guess this is an ASMR video about with sort of like typing noises. Okay. Just trying to think of different things that I've been talking with people about recently. I think that's a good way to drive this is, you know, what are things that I point people to or talk to people about or they ask about? Okay. Well, let me just typeset that and see what that looks like. Page. Huh. It's a little weird. Seems like there's something weird with the page breaks here with the Pandoc stuff. Oh well, as I fill in text, it'll resolve itself, I'm sure. So what, we're up to 6 pages? Kind of without lining. Wow, the page breaks are terrible. Well, oh well. Doesn't really matter. Okay, well, I did a largely silent writing session, but that's probably good. Actually, I should update my writing log. Okay, well, got in on the order of 2 hours there. We'll see. I mean, that one I wasn't really writing sentences. I was trying to collect a bunch of topics that have come up recently. Yeah, probably alternate going back and forth between adding topics and kind of filling out things. So I think that's a reasonable start, and hopefully I'll maintain my enthusiasm for this, and if not, I will switch to the Imperishable Wonderland and Imperishable Wonderland and work on that some, and then work back and forth. So anyway, I think part of the good thing about this big brain dump book is I am talking with a bunch of people about Minicanron on a regular basis in different contexts, and I think those questions and conversations will prompt me to work on this and do more and more brain dumps and try to fill in things. And even if I just end up with a whole bunch of topics and resources and pointers and some brief explanations of why I think this is interesting, or maybe it could be connected to another topic, hopefully that would be useful to at least some people. All right, that's enough for now. Talk to y'all later. Bye.